Now, for the majority of us, it's a no-brainer. When the time comes to vaccinate our children, we do. But for the kids who grow up in anti-vax households, it's a decision they have no choice in. That is, until they're old enough to make their own. Mike Thorpe reports.
In 2019, we've already seen 1,348 cases of measles in New Zealand. Around half of those affected weren't vaccinated. More than 500 others simply didn't know if they'd had their shots or not. The World Health Organization reports that immunization saves between 2 and 3 million lives every year. And every year, the vast majority of Kiwi parents have their kids vaccinated. Those who don't either don't have easy access, aren't sure, or are absolutely anti.
Well, Rebecca Thompson-Loy, it's great to talk to you. Now, you have never had a single vaccination until this year. Why did you decide to get vaccinated now at the age of 17?
So my family went on holiday to Southeast Asia in April, and my mum had been advised by her friends to get vaccinated against some diseases which are still around in third world countries. So she took us to the travel doctor and she strongly advised to go get vaccinated. And this was also the time of the measles outbreak. And personally, I just wanted to be protected myself. So I decided to start getting vaccinated regardless of whatever my parents thought, because it's my health and really it's my decision.
So what were you raised to believe about vaccination?
Just that they were bad in general. It was something for me that outsiders did, and you didn't want to be one of those outsiders because I was in such a tight-knit community. It was very alternative in every way possible, really. So not being vaccinated was just another one of those things.
How many injections have you had so far this year?
Roughly 20. So I had to get all the ones before going to Southeast Asia. And now since that I'm 17, I have to get many more rounds of all the shots to actually become immunized, because as a kid, you're meant to start when you're a baby, and then you are meant to be finished by the age of 4 or 6, I think my doctor told me. And you only need 1 or 2 rounds of each vaccine. However, I have to get 3 of every one, so I've been going to the doctors every 3 months and getting like 4 injections at one time, literally getting like 2 in each arm. I could like barely move the next day.
Oh, you must be so sick of those needles.
Yeah, I'm very over it, and it's so time consuming, and I wish if I'd had it done as a child, life would be so much easier now. Like, I'm year 13, I'm trying to finish school, I'm also working, and it's just so much to juggle, and then I also have to go to the doctors all the time, and I wish that it had just been done and I didn't have to deal with it now.
What do your parents think about your decision to get vaccinated?
My mother's okay with it. She's kind of come around, and she'll just let me do whatever I want, whereas my father, he's still more alternative, and he's been getting more into the alternative medicine and homeopathy and everything, and he himself is not into vaccines, and he'd prefer that I didn't get vaccinated. However, he realises that it is my choice. I'm over the age of 16, I can go to the doctors, get them myself, so he's, you know, there's nothing he can do about it, really.
What would you like to say to anti-vaxxers?
Just listen to the science, firstly, because it literally is science. Do your bit and keep the community safe, please.
Thanks so much, Rebecca. Lovely to talk to you. Bye.
Okay, bye.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
So Rebecca's still got a number of needles to cope with yet, but what an incredibly brave thing to do when you've grown up being taught something entirely different.